Schrumeyer here, medical exercise specialist and certified personal trainer from erniesfitnessworld.com. I wanted to show you a quick little video today about high intensity interval training. If you've read it, some of my articles on Hamilton Spectator, I talk about high intensity interval training sometimes. The thing is, it's a relative term. High intensity means that for what one person is high intensity, for somebody else might be easy. So I'm going to show you three ways you can do it if you're working in a gym or if you've got some home equipment. What I'm going to do is I'll show you the elliptical trainer, the treadmill, and the exercise bike. What I suggest is you take your total workout time, so if you're going to spend 12 minutes on one piece of equipment, add in every 2 to 3 minutes, do 20 to 30 second increase where you're pushing the speed up a little bit more than you would be able to do at that intensity at a longer pace, okay? So I'm going to show you some high intensity interval training right now. Alright, so I'm on an elliptical trainer here. I'm setting my recovery speed, my recovery pace at level 7. This piece of equipment goes up to 20 levels. So as we go along, what I'm going to do to be able to maintain some intensity, I'm going to push the levels up to 15. Now I'm going to pick up the pace, so I'm going to pick up the speed. Say for 20 seconds, and then bring back down, back to my recovery pace. The speed and the intensity should be at a level that you would not be able to maintain for longer than 20 seconds. Okay, on the treadmill, it's a little bit tricky. On the elliptical, the pace is set by how fast and how hard I go. The treadmill, as I'm increasing speed, if I can do my interval now, I'm going to bring it up to a much faster pace. It takes a few seconds to get there, so it's not as immediate. So I would say once you got up to that pace, now I'm at that pace for a few seconds, I can take 20 to 30 seconds at this faster speed. If you're able to, you can also take up to a jog or a run. Whatever's appropriate for you. Okay, so 20 to 30 seconds, I'm going to bring it back down. Alright, finally I'm on the exercise bike. So this is it's a computerized program bike that I'm going to set to a comfortable pace again, just like I did on the elliptical and treadmill. When I want to pick up the pace, I'm going to take the intensity, so the amount of pushing it takes is going to be higher. And I'm going to pick up my pace here, so I'm going to pick up the speed for about 20 seconds. Make sure that you're breathing. Okay, so at the 20 second mark, taking it back down. On the exercise bike, it's important that you add resistance. If you try to go super fast or just faster, with low resistance, you're gonna be bouncing up on the bike. You're gonna lose control of the pedals and it's not a really comfortable ride. Whew, that was tough. So there's three different ways that you can do high intensity interval work if you're in a gym. If you're outside and you're walking, every 2 to 3 minutes, just pick up your walking pace. What my favorite way to do it is to look and decide I'm going to go from that telephone pole to that stop sign. You know, and use that as an interval. Pick it up during that pace. Really important that if you haven't been cleared by a physician, if you have any concerns, that you check with your doctor first before you add in high intensity interval work into your program. You get great benefits, but you have to make sure that the risk is worth the reward. All right. So follow me on Facebook, like me on Facebook, follow me on Twitter, check out erniesfitnessworld.com, and make sure that you keep reading the Hamilton Spectator Fitness Solutions every Wednesday, and I'll see you soon.